Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to be having a look at what is again in another brown box. This is the Generation 2 Ubiquiti 48 port switch, the non-PoE. So this is the USW-48. So let's have a little look at what's in the box. We'll have a look at the unit itself in a moment. You're going to get a little conformity guide, not really much more than that. There for you. You are going to get two rack ears because this is a rack mountable unit. You are also going to get a little packet there of rack mount nuts and screws to allow you to mount that into the rack. And you're going to get a power cable for your region. We're here in Australia, so that's our end there and IEC at this end. There you go. All right, so to the unit itself. This is a fanless unit. All right, so it has airflow from front to back, or probably back to front as well. Let me just hold you the unit up here for you so you can have a good look. So like I said, this is the non-PoE version. We've got 48 ports on here, and we have 4 1-gig SFPs over on this side. So they're just 1 gig. Over on there, just down in that bottom corner, there is your reset switch. And then over on this side here, hopefully you've got used to this now, is our little Ubiquiti touchscreen. Gives us options to reboot the device, check its IP address and performance statistics, if I can get that word out as well. You'll also see across here, you can see these small gaps. This is where our air intake happens. And these are mirrored over here on the back as well. And you can see on this side here, we have our IEC power in. As you can see, no side vents here at all. It is just back and front. Hopefully this has been useful. This is the USW-48. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box openings on networking, wireless and firewall devices, plenty of how-to guides. What do I need to run Unify Network? How to manage this, control it, for instance, and what do I need to run Unify Protect? So do head on over there and subscribe to stay up to date, but hopefully that's been useful.